Viewer, and welcome to today's post on adding a keyboard shortcut to private browsing within Safari. Now, I've done a previous video on showing how to do a keyboard shortcut, but private browsing has a specific problem because it's got three full stops, known as ellipsis, according to Wikipedia, at the end of the word. Now, this is a little bit problematic because three full stops and an ellipsis are two different things. However, we can get around this very quickly and very easily. Adding a keyboard shortcut to private browsing is very simple. What we're going to use is the keyboard shortcut function within System Preferences. Open Applications, System Preferences, and select the Keyboard Preference pane. Select the Application Shortcuts button at the bottom and press the plus symbol. From the application drop-down list, select Safari and then type in private browsing. Now, here's the interesting point. If you want to have private browsing with the warning that comes up, add in three full stops. This replicates what we see within private browsing. Notice those three ellipses. However, if we press the Alt key, notice how it changes and it disappears. Private browsing with three ellipses comes up with a warning. Private browsing without the ellipses doesn't come up with any warning at all. Notice how we're in private browsing mode, but no warning appeared. So within System Preferences, we can either add the ellipsis or we can get rid of it. Let's add it for a bit of fun. Now we add in our keyboard shortcut, lots of options and modifiers and controls and functions and shift keys so we don't get our keyboard shortcut mixed up with anything else, and then press add. Now when we go back into Safari, we've got our ellipsis there. For some reason, it likes to duplicate this one. It's a bit of a strange one. However, now when we press our keyboard command, our warning comes up. If we edit this command by double clicking on it and removing the ellipsis, when we go back into Safari, it's now switched it round. So when we press our keyboard shortcut, we can go in and out of private browsing mode without the warning coming up. Quite useful actually this way, because you don't have to click on the button every time you want to go into private browsing mode. Now if you want to remove the keyboard shortcut or change it, to change it you simply select on the button and then you type in something else. To remove it you press the little minus key at the bottom and it's gone. So when you go back into Safari, it's back to normal. Adding ellipsis for the keyboard shortcuts is a little bit more difficult and takes a bit of thinking, however it's just as simple as adding a keyboard shortcut to any other menu bar item. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my channel where you'll find more Mac tricks and tips videos.